All right, vlog peeps, here we go. Episode number two. The good news is it's a recovery month for me. Today, I'm just gonna kind of take you through an easy run and then answer questions that I typically get about ultra running. My run, it's freezing out today. It's about 32 degrees. I'm gonna be dressing pretty warm for today. Let me show you what I'll be wearing.
We're out with obviously sports bra, tank, my sweet long sleeve Chicago Lakefront 5050, some good old Stance socks, I love those. Some warm, like thermal almost leggings, these are great. And then my running jacket. I'm wearing a headband today, can you believe it already? I can't. And my gloves. Oh, one thing I wanted to show you, I love this sunscreen. Get this, I'll link it below in the comments. As much as you sweat, it doesn't come off, so go out and get some. See, Mom, aren't you proud? I wear sunscreen. All right, let's get dressed and go out for this run.
Hey, guys. So here we are. This is the trail I usually run on. It's a lakefront path. It takes about 5 minutes for me to just run down onto the trail, so a little bit of a warm-up. I'm really glad I wore the gloves and the headband today because it is crisp out here, but beautiful and a great day. So let's get this run going. Woo! And I'm going to make my way back here. Ended up taking off the gloves, it got a little warm. The sun is beautiful today, just love it. And check out what's right behind me. Ooh, a little John Hancock for ya. All right, let's roll. All right, so we are back from the run. Went well, everything felt good. It's an absolutely beautiful day. Now I'm gonna head inside and do a little foam rolling, and some core work, just super chill stuff. So foam rolling and core is now done. I'll be making my smoothie for you. So usually after workouts, I'll make a smoothie right away. All right, so this is a terrible angle. Yo, I've got banana in here. Almond milk, some blueberries. I've got kale. I usually use kale or spinach. This is actually a mix of both. Justin's almond butter. I combo mix that I'll put in the comments. Hemp seeds, flax seed, and chia seed. This is a new thing I'm trying. Vital proteins, collagen, peptides. Okay, it's for joints and bones. Good, healthy joints and bones. I'll link it in the comments. Rave about it. I add cinnamon to pretty much everything. It's a great anti-inflammatory because inflammation isn't fun. Causes disease and injury. Put it in. I have one of these Cuisine Arts. I got it for Christmas 1 year. Shout out to the Nolans. I believe they gave this to us. Thumbs up ski. Put it on high. I won't put this on video because it's really annoying. Sorry, downstairs neighbors. All right, so there you have it, your recovery smoothie. Last but not least, I wanted to talk about ultra running. Ultra marathon is anything over the marathon distance, which is 26.2. So typical ultra marathons will race at a distance of a 50K, a 50 miler, 100K, and 100 miles. If you're interested in trying to find a race that might fit what you're looking for, you can look on Ultra Sign Up. That's where I go to look for all mine. Another question I get about running 100 miles is, do you sleep? Or do you stop? No. You don't really want to be stopping to rest for too long, or at least I don't. In any kind of ultra marathon or 50K or 50 miler, my goal is to get from point A to point B as fast as I possibly can. Running at night, you're usually running with a headlamp on, which is a lot easier than it sounds. It's super fun and super crazy and sometimes scary, most of the time scary. What do you eat or drink while running? I have a terrible stomach. I can't take in dairy, I can't take in gluten, I get really sick. I'm running 50K or a 50 miler, I won't eat anything besides gels. If that's just what works for me, that's not what works for everyone.
I'll start eating some like salt and vinegar chips.
I really like those. Maybe drinking a little Mountain Dew.
But other than that,
anything more than that tends to upset my stomach.
Another question I get
is, how do you stay motivated? You just kind of have to find that little bit of something to get you out the door. Get on, you know,
social media and maybe
look at a runner that inspires me, see what they did today, or watch a quick YouTube video when it's necessary.
So
taking November as a rest and recovery month, I'll show you more of what that means in the next episode coming up here.
Until then,
if you have any questions, like I said, leave them in the comments. Stay healthy, stay happy, and I'll see you next time.